Is it true? Is it true that there is a God out there in this universe? Is it true that I am fearfully and wonderfully made? How can it be? After everything I've done, what compels an almighty, all-powerful being to know me? Could it be love? Unconditional love. Love that is not of man. A love that is beyond all comprehension. The kind of love that would break through the barriers of society, religion, and the law. This is the love of God. He came down for all of us, for the saint and the sinner, for the just and the unjust. He came down to show a better way. He came down to give us direct and unfettered access to the Father. He came down to forgive us. But why forgive us? We who betrayed him? We who deserved to die in our sin? We who rejected him from the moment mankind chose to turn away from the life of God, we had no escape. But still, despite our unclean, filthy rags, he chose to love us. He knows each and every one of us by name. We are his. He gave sight to the blind. He healed with no prejudice or presumption. He taught us what it means to be loved by God, and he instructed us to share this love with everyone. But this was not without cost. Sin had to be atoned for, and a sacrificial lamb was necessary. Who better than God himself in the flesh? He knows us by name, and he knows our sorrow. He stood innocent before his accusers. He endured so much more than any man ever has or ever will. He willingly bore each of our sins on that cross, bloody, beaten, bruised, and broken, for me, for you, forever. Enduring immeasurable suffering, he cried out,
"It is finished!"
With his last breath, he thought not to save himself, but to be obedient to death on the cross. With obedience comes reward, the reward of eternal life. Three days after Jesus' death, the ground began to shake, and the stone of his grave was rolled away. When the disciples came to the tomb, Jesus' body was gone. They were in shock. Somebody must have stolen his body, they thought. Who would do this to our beloved Jesus? But others had faith. He has risen, they said. He has defeated death. He has overcome the grave. And finally, Jesus appeared to them, their resurrected King. Because of what Jesus did for us, we also can have that reward of eternal life. If we have faith in God as Jesus had faith in his Father, we too can die and rise again in Christ.
I died. I had to. That repentance and forgiveness might be proclaimed. Now, I am alive forevermore. Do some of you still doubt? Even those closest to me could not always see me. I am the way, the truth, and the life. None come to the Father but through me. Receive my mercy and be saved. You are my witnesses. Go, tell all the nations of me and my salvation.
Oh God,
Here am I, send me you.